Champagne Dreamers, welcome back to my channel. I'm your girl, Miss J, and I forgot my intro. Hello, Champagne Dreamers, welcome back to my channel. I'm your girl, Miss J, the trash queen of glam, geek, and gore. And for today's video, we are finally, I think this is it. I think this is the last video in my 2020 declutter series. Can you believe we finally made it? Now, in the spirit of ending this declutter, really, this is just me going through all the random shit that somehow I either forgot to put into previous videos, or it's just in a different spot. It's brands that I didn't really have enough to make them as part of their own brand declutter. It's a whole lot of random shit. If you want to see all the random shit, definitely go over to JanessaJ.com. There is a whole separate post that's going to show you all the collection that I looked at for this part of the declutter. And then in this video, you'll be able to see what it is that I actually decided to get rid of. So if you're interested in that, definitely stick around. We're getting into this declutter, the finale, the end of the road.
So we've come to the end of the road.
Yikes. If you're interested in that, then stick around, get comfortable, because we're getting into it right now. All right, Champagne Dreamers, we are in the final declutter, and this one is just randomness. So these are all products that just ended up in weird places in my office. I have a bunch of bins where I'm trying to organize things for videos, or I've pulled brands together, or just different themes, and I've got a couple kind of oddball storage containers, and so it's a little mishmash of a bunch of different things. So we're gonna start with some products that are in a little three-drawer container that I have off to my side here. So above my main large container, I have one of those little craft storage ones, and that's where I store a lot of glitter, neon pigments, and lashes, and a bunch of things. So the top drawer of the organizer is glitter. And I love glitter, but I have too much glitter. We're gonna go ahead and clear out some of the glitter. So first of all, we have this little purple glitter. This is from the Anastasia Halloween collection from a couple years ago. I like these little glitters. I think they're cute, but this purple, I don't use a ton of purple glitter. This is like got a fun kind of holographic element to it, but I just got a couple new purple glitters from Trixie Cosmetics when the Back to the Fuchsia collection came out, so this one can go. And then these are the neon glitters from BH Cosmetics. These came out with a neon collection. I think it might have been the Take Me to Rio, whatever the like second version of the Carnival palette that they did. These are fine, but they take up so much room. And like this red with yellow is very unique, but I've tried to use it and it just looks like a rash. It's not great. And I have a ton of other glitter. So I was like, you know what? The BH Cosmetics, I love their eyeshadow. I don't need of their glitter. This is a beautiful set of glitters that I got from the Lipstick Apocalypse. I don't think they're around anymore, or maybe they're rebranding or something, but this was actually gifted to me by Nicole, the owner of Lipstick Apocalypse. She's friends with my friend Mary, who makes my beautiful Swarovski lashes. You definitely won't be seeing any Swarovski lashes in this declutter. Those are mine forever. But when I placed my order, she went ahead and threw this rainbow set in so that I could try some of her loose glitters. And I thought they were fun, but again, I've got so many glitters and a lot of these chunkier glitters, I'm a little nervous because they're not really eye safe. And you know what? These little jars are cute, but these take up a lot of room. So I just decided, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and get rid of these and pass them on to somebody who will appreciate them. And then I have some random glitter gels. These are three from the Lipstick Apocalypse as well. These dried up. This plastic container is not airtight enough, and so these unfortunately dried up. So I've tried to like revive them different ways, and it just hasn't worked out. So I decided to go ahead and get rid of these. Same thing happened with the Tarte. This I've used quite a bit of. I use this in a lot of Face Fridays. We got pretty far down, but now it's pretty much solidified. And this is one that I got from BH Cosmetics, and I honestly just included this to get free shipping. I think I was ordering just like one or two palettes, and I was trying to get to their free shipping threshold, and this was on sale, and so I just bought it. And I played with it once or twice and just decided it could go to somebody else. I love my Lemonhead LA glitters. This can't hold a candle to it. I also have cake liners in that little organizer, and this I reviewed fairly recently. This is the Bitchin' Cake Liner from Midas Cosmetics, and I just had a hard time with this. I mean, this has dried up, and it looks almost untouched, but I did review this and show off all the shades, but I couldn't get it to work for me. I'm not great with eyeliner. I'm not great with cake eyeliners. I love these greens. You know, I love this pink and this pink. It's kind of an odd mix of colors, and I just couldn't get very good performance out of them. I admitted in the review it might be user error because I'm not super adept at these. I just didn't have the luck with these that I had with the Glam Vice liners and the ABH liners, so I decided to get rid of this palette. Couple other random things. This is from the Blueprint collection from Melt Cosmetics. This is the shade Slate, and I do kind of like their gel colors, but this sort of matte navy blue is not a color I'm going to use again. I did keep the more metallic, lighter blue shade, but this dark blue is just not one I'm probably going to use. And then this is Smitten. This is a pigment from Sugar Pill. It's pretty, but I don't use loose pigments a lot. And then these were from Peachy Queen. I wish that they had a permanent collection of lashes, because these Sweet Treat lashes from Peachy Queen are delightful. It's just that this pair, I wore them once as lower lashes. I haven't really been wearing lower lashes as much. This is in the style Buttercream, and they're cute, but I just need to get rid of these. I wish they would bring these back. And rounding out the randomness in that organizer, this is the like Glitter Blood from BH Cosmetics. I have panned that Halloween collection so many times. I just talk trash about it all the time. So I'm absolutely decluttering the fake blood glitter gel as well. This is one of the colored pencils, the like chubby sticks from KVD. This is the orange one. I kept the hot pink and the electric blue, but this orange, I'm never gonna use that. She real orange. I don't use a lot of orange. That's not me. It's just not my look. And a couple random glosses from Too Faced. This melted gold, I think I just bought because the packaging looked like unicorn tears and a couple other things. It's just a gold gloss. It's a fine gold gloss, but it's just a gold gloss. So this is gonna go, and then I have 3 or 4 of these like pretty rich glosses, and they're pretty, but I have 2 of them that are kind of similar with this like sheer iridescent base that's kind of pink. And so I kept the one that's a little bit more pink. This one is a little bit more like pink and blue. And so I decided to get rid of this shade. All right, then I have a bin of products that I put together when I was doing the Reefer Madness video. I'll go ahead and link that up here in the corner. Please, please, please check out that video. Not only did I talk about some of these great marijuana themed products and showed off a look that I had done as a Face Friday that I'll link below that was using all marijuana themed or cannabis derived ingredient type products, but it was also a lot about legalization, which is something I really care about. So please, please, please check out that video. But here are some things that I'm decluttering from that bin. These are some glitters from Midas Cosmetics. There was 2 groups of 5 and I kept 3 of them, but I decided to get rid of 7 of them. They're just big chunky glitters. And so I kept a couple that I felt like were a little more unique, a little bit more useful in my collection, but I decided to go ahead and declutter this set right here. Then we have the OMFG Kush Queen palette. This is a pretty palette, but it's not great by any means. There are some interesting swampy, grungy greens in here, but they're not anything that's unique to my collection. You know, this shade right here is pretty, but I have that 10 times. And I just don't need this. It's kind of that private label packaging. You know, shades fall out, they come unglued. And there's just nothing in here that makes me have to keep it. And then we have the Up in Smoke by Peachy Queen. This is a beautiful palette, except that it's all super neutral. So I used like 1 shade from this in the look that I did for the Reefer Madness video. I think I used this shade Stoner. And there are some beautiful, like Ganja's beautiful, Sweet Leaf is beautiful. The shimmers are pretty, but it's just more neutrals, and I just don't need it in my collection. Peachy Queen is pretty random with their quality. Some is really good, some is kind of eh, some is really off. This one is kind of more middle of the road, but it's just not shades I see myself using a lot. If I'm gonna reach for neutrals, I'm probably not reaching for this palette. Also in that bin, I had some lip blazes from Lime Crime. I think I had 3 shades. I kept one of them just for kind of reference to kind of remember the formula. And I kept one shade that was a little bit better for me. But these, they're very nude. That was kind of the thing. They were these like glossy nude lip colors that had cannabis seed oil in them. And they're fine, but I just don't need these. They're getting a little bit old. And then there was the Milk Kush Mascara. This is just a little travel tube that I picked up so that I would have a mascara that went with the theme when I did the Reefer Madness video. And it's cute, but she's getting a little bit old and it's a little bit dry. And so these can all get decluttered as well. And then, of course, we have some of the gloss from Jeffree Star Cosmetics. Now, I'm sort of meh about the gloss. I don't love it as a formula. I don't think it's terrible. But these are all ones that are just from the regular line. Any of the ones that were from special collections, like the Orgy Collection or the Bloodlust Collection or the Blood Money Collection, I kept those. And any of the ones that were Mystery Box exclusives, I kept. But a lot of these just came from Mystery Boxes and they're from the main line. And so, like this black one, I don't need to keep this because I kept the black Supreme gloss. And how many black glosses do I need? And if I'm gonna try to use a black gloss, I'm gonna use the one that's more opaque. These are just colors that I'm like, I can get rid of these. They're duplicates in my collection. They were ones that I got in mystery boxes, or even if I picked them up, I just haven't used them. So these are all getting decluttered. There are 7 glosses here. These labels are impossible for my old ass eyes to read, so I can't tell you exactly what shades they are, but they're from the main collection. They're not from any of the special collections. Next up, I had a bin of products that contained all different kinds of products from Black-owned makeup brands. I've done a couple of videos on my channel. I'll go ahead and link the first one up here in the cards, and I'll make sure that both of them are linked down below. But I've done a couple videos about Black-owned makeup brands that aren't Fenty or Pat McGrath, and so I had a bin that was filled with a bunch of products from those brands. So I went through and I did find some things to declutter, starting with these little cushion pots from Danessa Myricks. I kept one shade, which was kind of a neon yellow, but this neon orange and this electric blue, I've decided these can go. I don't like working with cushions because I'm not very good at it. I don't know how to get the right amount of product. So this is Blue Skies, and this is Totally Tangerine. These are beautiful colors, but I just have trouble using them. And then we have 3 little sample jars that I got from 1675 Cosmetics. They, I don't think, are around anymore. So these are little pigments, a yellow and a green. I think these might actually be full size. I think I ordered these. But I think this is one that they threw in as a sample. This is like a lip gloss that's kind of a maroon. I just don't, these, I don't like loose pigments. I just make a mess whenever I open them. And these little jars especially seem to just like throw pigment everywhere. And this little maroon, this has gotten a little bit old. It never smelled very good. It's got that kind of generic petroleum jelly based lip gloss kind of smell to it. So I'm gonna go ahead and declutter these. But I would love it if 1675 made a comeback because they were fantastic. From Minted Cosmetics, I have a blush, and this is in the shade Buried Away. And this is really pretty, but it's just too deep for me. I thought that I would be able to sheer it out, but as expected from a Black-owned makeup brand, it is very pigmented. It's got a beautiful, rich color, and it's just too impactful for me to really do what I need it to do. And it's a beautiful color, but it's too dark. So I'm gonna go ahead and pass this along to somebody else who will use it. I have the Peach Blush, which is phenomenal. But this one, just a little too dark for my preferences. And then we have some lipsticks from Proppa Beauty. I'll go ahead and link the reviews down below. I have reviewed some of the original launch of Proppa Beauty, as well as their Reds collection. And I kept some of them, but it's a little bit slicker, shinier of a lipstick formula than I like. So the ones where the color isn't like really suited to me, I decided to go ahead and declutter them. So this is the shade Primetime. And you can see it's easy for them to get banged up because they are such a slick, soft formula. They kind of move around in the packaging, and so they can be a little tough to keep nice. They are a beautiful shiny lipstick, and if you like something that's like a lipstick that also feels a little bit like a balm, these would be a great option for you. And this is the shade Prowess. This is another one of those brown neutral lipsticks. I keep trying to convince myself that I need brown neutral lipsticks, and I'm always wrong. This is the shade Dynamite, which is a beautiful bright red, but when I think of reds, I want full opacity. I usually want a matte finish, so this is beautiful, but it's just the wrong formulation for me to really enjoy it. And finally, this is the shade Empower. I do sometimes, if I wear a brown, I wear a deep, deep brown. And this is beautiful, but in my lipstick video, I showed off that I had a lipstick from Gold Label Cosmetics, and I do still have a deep, deep lipstick from Gold Label, and it's much more matte, much more opaque, so I decided to go ahead and declutter this one. These are liquid lipsticks from Lena Lashes. I love Lena Lashes for lashes. I don't love these liquid lipsticks. They're fine. They're just like clearly cheapy private label, just kind of basic formulas. There's not anything really special about them. The colors are pretty run of the mill. These are getting a little bit old. They're starting to separate a little bit more. And I love Lena Lashes for lashes, but these liquid lipsticks just don't need to hang around in my collection anymore. So this is a gloss from the Lip Bar, and this is in the shade Trophy Wife. It's a pretty champagne gloss. It's just nothing special about it that makes me need to keep it. I've got so many basic glosses. I do love their packaging, but I've got some of their liquid lipsticks that have the same kind of filigree packaging. I've got the lipstick, the liquid lipstick and the stick lipstick. And so this lip gloss can just go. It's too basic. I just don't really need it anymore. And these are a couple of products from Lip Addict. This is a Black-owned makeup brand that unfortunately I don't think is around anymore. This is a liquid lipstick and this is a lip gloss. This lip gloss was so beautiful, but these just have gotten really old and they're not aging very well. Like this lip gloss, yeah, it's starting to get a weird smell. It had like a cinnamon smell in it, but now it kind of smells like cinnamon and clay, which is not great. So we're gonna go ahead and throw these out. I did keep a green one because the green one didn't smell as bad as these two. It kind of still smelled like when it was fresher. And it was more just kind of as a remembrance of this brand because I did enjoy them, but I did go ahead and declutter these two. This is a little liquid lipstick from Vault Cosmetics by Jackie Megiddo. She is now known as Jackie Megiddo Cosmetics. This is just getting a little bit old. This again is from when I was shopping for my very first round of Black-owned makeup brands. This one has been around for a while and it's just getting a little bit old, a little bit dried out. I need to update this. And it's brown. We've talked about brown lipsticks. I don't know why it's the lesson that I can't seem to learn. And then I've got a couple of these Colored Rain metallic liquid lipsticks. I do really like the Colored Rain liquid lipstick formula. This one is just a little bit older. This is called Cotton Candy. This one I've had for a while and it's starting to get streaky and not very good. And this pink just does not look right on me. I don't know why. I tried it on and there's something about that color with my skin tone. It just turns a weird color. It just looks very strange and it's not flattering. So I decided to go ahead and declutter both of these. Now, if you watched my second Black-owned makeup brand video, if you missed it, I'll go ahead and link it up in the cards. But if you watched that video, you know that Black Radiance may not even be a Black-owned makeup brand. I think it's one that sort of certainly is thought of as a Black-owned makeup brand. It caters to people with darker skin tones, and they're not doing anything to like dispel the myth, but I think it might actually not be Black-owned, but I'm not 100% sure. I found some articles that seem to indicate that it wasn't. So I decluttered a few things from them. This matte red lipstick is just one that I got as a free gift with an order. So that's easy to get rid of. I've got a ton of red lipstick. And then this green Lid Glitz, this is a liquid shadow. I don't need any more liquid shadows in my life. It looks so beautiful on the wand, and then you try to paint it on and it's streaky and not great. And then this highlighter palette, these colors are really beautiful, but it's so much packaging for these pans and they're great, but like this champagne is never the champagne I'm gonna reach for. This is way too dark for my skin tone. This is the only one that I would really keep, but all this packaging taking up all this room for one purple highlighter, I have other purple highlighters. So this is gonna get passed along. So this is the Slush palette from September Rose Cosmetics. If you watched my videos, you know I love this palette. But I did decide to declutter this because these shadows are lovely, but the mirror came broken. So I decided not to ask for a replacement. I know that indie brands, it can be tough. It's hard out here in the world. So I just taped over it right away. It had like a plastic sheet protecting the shadows, so I knew there wasn't any glass. And none of the glass seemed to have fallen out. And so I just like went ahead and just taped it right away. But I've decided, you know what? I like this palette enough because these are beautiful, beautiful shades. My only complaint that I noted in the video is I hate, like with rainbow palettes, if there's five rows, there's a whole row of like red and pink, of orangey peach, of blues, of purples, and then yellow and green get smushed together. And I love yellow shadows and I love green shadows. So that's my one complaint about this, but at some point I wanna order the Slush 2 palette. And so when I do that, I'm gonna order a replacement for this so that I don't have the broken mirror. So I'm gonna go ahead and pass this along to someone who will love it as much as I did. And I finally decided it was time to get rid of my box of crayons. This was such a moment in the YouTube beauty space when everybody was getting their box of crayons palette. And, you know, there were all those different reviews and everything. I think it's beautiful. I still think it's great. I mean, it's one of those that does have a little bit of the oil seepage from the shimmers, which isn't always great, but we see that from a lot of brands. And these are beautiful shades, but I just was like, you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and pass this along. It's kind of a big, bulky palette. It doesn't make a lot of sense in my collection, so I'm gonna go ahead and pass this along. That shade was a little bit of a dud, and that's my favorite shade in the palette. That also hurts my heart, so. Lime Green, I just wanted to love you. Then I had another bin that was all of my Karen makeup. So my Karen makeup, if you didn't see the Face Friday, I'll go ahead and link that down below. But I did a look using all products from brands that I think of as like Karen brands, meaning I feel like I'm a little too white trash to use them. I love them, but they're a little bit expensive, and so I try to partake in them when there's a sale, but I still feel like somebody's gonna be like, that's not for you. We're gonna take that away. So this is the foundation from Marc Jacobs. This was on sale, and let me tell you, this is not my shade. There was a very limited shade selection, so I'm glad I didn't pay the full $54 or whatever it was. I still ended up paying like $28 or $27 or something ridiculous, but I got it for much less. But I just got the one that was closest to me, and this is dark for me. I mean, it wasn't quite painting myself into a hate crime, but it was close. So I do not feel comfortable continuing to use this foundation. Even, I mean, if you have a foundation that's too dark, you can lighten it with concealer and do all these things, but I also just didn't like the feel of it enough to jump through all those hoops to make it usable. So this one is gonna go. Then from Pat McGrath, we have this. I have finally given in and bought a few more expensive things from Pat McGrath, but I bought this when it was on clearance or whatever because it was the shimmery one and it was more colorful. But this packaging is a goddamn McDonald's Happy Meal toy. I cannot believe that they had the nerve to charge like close to $30 for these little mini palettes when they first came out. I think they were like $29 because I think I got mine for $14.50. And I mean, this cheap, shitty plastic, Pat McGrath, you should be ashamed. This is ridiculous. So this piece of garbage is gonna go. And the other things that I have from the Karen bucket are all from Natasha Denona. So we have the Glow Gold. This is a little highlighter duo. And these are fun, like shimmery, and they're kind of squishy, and you can see I've made a bit of a dent. And I've played with these a little bit, but they're just like a glitter explosion, which I love glitter, but then just use glitter. Like, the highlight on this is kind of sketch. Like, when you get past the glitter, the like base part of it is not like consistent enough. And so you have these beautiful like swaths of glitter, but they're just kind of inconsistent. And for as much as she charges now, I've said this before and I'll say it again, I don't think I've ever bought anything except maybe like one of these, not this one, but one of these like little mini palettes from Natasha Denona. I've paid full price. All of the other things I got on clearance or with a coupon or something, but I this needs to go. This needs to go as well. This I got half off. I don't know if I thought I was going to buy the Lila palette, so I bought this to go with it. I'm done with that collecting mentality. I don't love these shades. I'm probably not going to buy the Lila palette ever, so this can go as well. All right, then we have the Natasha Denona Tropic palette. Sort of. So I, for whatever reason, I have no qualms at all about rearranging and moving around and customizing my Natasha Denona palettes. I feel like I spend enough money on them. And so this is starting as the Tropic palette. And you can see it's very, very neutral. But there's a couple shades. These three shades for sure, I know I pulled out of the Circo Loco palette and put these in here. And then there's like, I think these two are from the Trio Chrome palette. And so I took out the shades. I knew I wanted the whole bottom row from this. I ended up wanting two shades from the Trio Chrome that I threw into, or two shades from here that I threw into the Trio Chrome. And so I just have customized this a little bit. So this all neutral one with these couple brighter pops, this is going to go to somebody else because this is all warm, bright, neutral kind of stuff. It's not the kind of stuff I use. So you're not getting the original Tropic palette, but really all of this was Tropic palette and this wasn't that different from the Tropic palette. So that palette was kind of boring to start with. So this is my customized declutter. And then we have the Diamond and Blush palette in Daria. And Sephora finally stopped having the citrus. I looked at the citrus and almost ordered it so many times. But I don't know. Natasha Denona, her highlighters and blushes are just not as pigmented as I would like. I don't know if when you're rich and fancy and can buy this kind of shit all the time at full price, if you just don't care if there's any pigment because you just use it down to the pan in like two goes and then you just buy a new one. But I was like, this is not the tea, sis. Like, this is just weak. Like, this is fairly weak. There's some pretty colors, but it's so hard to get a decent pigmentation from it. So I'm going to go ahead and pass this along to somebody else who will use it for more every day. Because again, I mean, I say that, but I also recognize I'm an industrial application and this is not industrial, ma'am. All right. And then in the bottom of my little organizer, I have a miscellaneous drawer. It's kind of like the junk drawer in every Midwesterner's house. And it's where kind of overflow things from like the lash drawer or the glitter drawer go. And it's just a lot of random stuff. So there was a lot of MAC pigments. I decided to get rid of this kind of fleshy toned pigment. The label is way too small to read. And this kind of fleshy tone. And then there's a pink and a green glitter. These are gonna go. And then there were these two neon glitters that came in like some Halloween kit. I don't know why I kept these. I mean, they're fun, but I've got other neon glitters that are a much better quality than this. This is an old Tony and Tina glitter. I miss Tony and Tina glitters. And there's one they have, I can't remember what it's called, but it's pink and green and it's beautiful. But this silver one, Gateway, I'm just gonna go ahead and pass that along. And then there's this Kryolan, which is like a white base, loose pigment glitter that's got like a strong teal blue shift. I've got a mixed glitter from Kryolan that I'm keeping, but this pigment, I just don't use loose pigments enough for it to make sense. And then that drawer is also where most of my Jeffree Star minis, the last round of mystery boxes that I did, I got the red liquid lipstick collection, and most of those are going, if not all of them. There's a couple from the Morphe collab in here. Some of those were in the Morphe drawer, some are here. I'm just clearing out a lot of my Jeffree Star products. I'm not clearing out all of it, and I'm not saying that I'm never gonna buy from him again, but these minis I don't really love, and so all of these are getting passed along. Oh, and there's this little baby gloss from Shiseido. Cute, but too small. Needs to go. Oh, and I found this red MAC glitter too. It rolled behind some other things, so that's gonna go as well. And then there's just some absolute junky lashes. People give me little like throwaway lashes all the time. And sometimes I'll use them. Like these are the kind of lashes that I would maybe use as bottom lashes. And I've wanted to play around with like cutting these in half and using just like half a lash as a bottom lash. These could be good for that, but these are just too small. These just look like plastic, like twist ties. They're just not great quality. So these are gonna go. I've got these 199s that I got at a beauty supply store. I don't really wear the 199s, just the plain ones anymore. I like ones that have a little bit more flaring on the outer edge, a little bit smaller on the inner edge. A couple of lashes from OMFG. I've got some red lashes from Likely Lashes that if I'm going to do a red look, I'm going to use those. So I'm going to get rid of these. And these would maybe work as like a lower lash, but both of these came in a mystery box, and I'm just not going to be heartbroken getting rid of these. These were from some Halloween makeup kit. I like the idea of it, but these lashes with the little tinsel thing, they never look right when you put them on. And then these I got from Medusa's Makeup in a subscription box, and these are like cheapo plastic, so these are all going to go. A lot of these honestly are probably just going to go in the garbage just because they really are not great quality. I have a couple friends that wear lashes that I'll let them look at them. If they don't take them, they're just gonna get trashed. Sorry. And as you can see, I got this on clearance at Ulta for $5.49. This is a Model's Own Face Glitter Kit. I was drawn in by these holographic, huge, chunky glitters, but I have never used this. I don't imagine I'm going to use this. These are fun, but I much prefer a glitter gel for these big, chunky ones, so I decided to just go ahead and declutter this. Someone will love this. It'll be playful for somebody, but I just am not getting the use out of it, so I'm going to go ahead and pass that along. And the last thing from that drawer is a fish brush. I think I got a bunch of these from Mama Champagne. I think she got them on like Shop Miss A or something. I like the idea of these, but I am such an industrial application. I use so much foundation that using a foundation brush at all is a challenge for me. And something like this, I tried using one once and it just gets caked solid. And like, even if I wash it after one application, like, it's just never the same. So I'm gonna go ahead and pass that along. Like, for me, it's not Revlon, it's Dutch Boy. So somebody who's a little bit more normal in the amount of makeup that they use, this might be beautiful for them. So I'll go ahead and pass that along. Alright, so that was everything that I had for the miscellaneous declutter. However, as I was getting everything finished up, and I had already put together the post over on JanessaJ.com, don't forget, if you want to see the whole collection of everything that I went through, head on over to JanessaJ.com and check out the post to see the whole collection. But I found another bin of products. It was all of my products from when I went shopping in Ireland. So I'd been in Cork, Ireland. I'll go ahead and link that video up in the cards. I did a whole video where I showed off the whole collection. So instead of taking pictures and adding it to the post and putting the things in here, I decided to include a live declutter. Since it's just one bin, why not? Let's go ahead and do it. And it'll be a little treat for those of you who love to watch the decision-making process. So this is another bin. This is all the products that I picked up when I was on my trip to Ireland. So we're gonna go ahead and look through these and declutter as we go. So I started shopping while I was still in the airport. When I was in the airport in London, I found a Boots and they had Max Factor. So Max Factor pretty much disappeared from the US a long time ago and they haven't really made their way back, but you can still get them in Europe and in the Philippines and places like that. So I decided to pick up a few things and I'm actually gonna hold on to all of this. So this is the Radiant Lift Foundation. This is a radiant foundation, so I will probably declutter this at some point. But I'm gonna go ahead and give this a try because I had intended to do a full face of makeup that I picked up in Ireland and I bought a few foundations. I'm gonna go ahead and hold on to this even though it looks a little too yellow for me and it's radiant, so I think it's gonna be too greasy, too bright and shiny. But I'm gonna go ahead and hold on to it just because it's Max Factor and that feels precious to me because when I first started drag, you used to be able to get Max Factor at Walmart and almost all of my early drag makeup before I discovered MAC and started getting fancy was Max Factor. So I also have this one. This is the Lasting Performance. This I think is like a demi matte, and so this is the one that's more likely for me. But I'm gonna go ahead and keep both of these. And then I have two of their Lipfinities. So if you hate liquid lipsticks, blame these bitches right here, because these, as far as I know, were the first ones on the market. At the time, they were calling them demi-permanent, And these came out a long, long time ago. Like, they first came out, like, 20 years ago. Something like that. Because I've been doing drag for about 20 years, and I think I had them from pretty much almost the very beginning. Now, these are two shades that I picked up. They are so dry, and the company even knew they were super dry when they launched them. And so they each came with a lip balm. And I use the lip balm just as a balm, so I've actually used up one of the balms that came with these. I'm going to keep both these shades, and I'm going to keep the lip balm. So, no declutter yet. I always warn you that I'm not a savage declutterer, and here you can see it's absolutely true. These are products from two Irish brands that were recommended to me by Christine O'Connor. She's a makeup artist from Cork, and I found her on YouTube before I went on my trip when I was still planning it. And so I had messaged her and I was like, are there any beauty brands I should be on the lookout for? And she told me about some Irish brands. One of them is a brush company. I have the brushes over in my holder over there. But she told me about Fuchsia Makeup and Luna by Lisa Jordan. So I picked up some things. Let me tell you, this Fuchsia Makeup palette, this isn't even the one that I wanted, but I trekked my happy ass all over County Cork trying to find a stockist for Fuchsia Makeup. I kept getting the wrong directions and I would go to the wrong place, and there's so many things that have similar names and I just could not find it. It took me forever, and it was the last day of my trip and I finally tracked down this nudes palette. So I am 100% keeping this, even though it's kind of odd, and if you watch my video you'll find out some weirdness with the names. But even though it's a nude palette, I'm going to hold on to this just because it has sentimental value. It was an adventure, and I discovered this little fishing village called Kinsale, and that's where I finally found it, and so I'm going to go ahead and keep that. I am going to declutter the lipstick, though. So this is the shade, is it just Raspberry? Raspberry Freeze. And this is a beautiful deep red, but it's just not my kind of color. And I'm going to go ahead and declutter that. It's a little too dark. I'm sure I'll find somebody who would love it. I am, however, going to keep both of the lip sets, Flame and Morganite, from Luna by Lisa Jordan. These are lip liners, and then there's a matching lipstick. And these lipsticks are actually really good. So this is kind of a nudie, mauve-y pink, but it's really good. And then Flame, oh my god. So Flame is gorgeous. It's this, like, bright coral red. Ah, it's so wild. I love it. So I'm going to hold on to both of those. So again, not too savage, but these bring back some great memories. So now we're getting into more like drugstore brands. And a lot of the drugstore brands are from England or they're from other places in Europe. Now, CYO actually was on clearance when I was there, and I found out later that it was on clearance because it was actually disappearing. They didn't really give anybody much of a heads up, but they just kind of disappeared out of the market. So these have less sentimental value. All the stuff that we're going to see from here on out, much less sentimental value, so we're going to be probably a little bit harsher. But let's go through. This is a blush, and I can't open anything. That's a little too dark. I'm going to declutter that. And then there's this pink blush. I'm going to hold on to that for now, just because I do think I still want to do like a full face of makeup from that trip. But I like this color, but I like it better than the other, so I'll keep this one. And then we've got these three metallic liquid lipstick. These are a lot of fun. I'm going to go ahead and declutter the pink one. Although I do like that one. Should I keep all of these? I'm going to go ahead and keep all of these. I need to play with this formula more, especially since you can't get it. Metallic liquid lipsticks are hard to make, and they're hard to make well. So if these are good, now I'm going to try them out. If they're terrible, I'm going to go ahead and junk them if they're not good. But these colors are really pretty, so if they do perform, I'm going to want to hold on to these. All right, these kind of pigment paints. Call me predictable, but I'm going to declutter the blue and keep the green. I love a green moment. I'm going to keep this one and declutter this one. Oh, and I always say how much I hate, like, combined face palettes that are, like, blush and bronzer and highlight. And then when two of them are cream products, but one is a powder, oh, this is going for sure. This one's decluttered. What is in this one? I think this one is just, like, a highlight contour. I'm going to get rid of both of these. Neither of these really impress me. If I'm going to hold on to the CYO, I would rather hold on to the colorful stuff. So these are going to go. These are a couple of face products. I tried to get a range because, again, I was planning to do a full face. So I tried to get a little bit from every category. So when I was trying different brands, I would try different things. So I don't know if I made wise choices. This is a hydrating and radiance foundation. This is getting decluttered. Radiant, I'm an oily beast. This is not going to match. I'm keeping both of the Max Factor foundations, so there's no reason for me to keep this. I am going to keep this little green color corrector, though. I think I'm going to try this out because, you know what? I love... Is that... Oh, it's just loose in there. That's why. It's hot in my office, so sometimes cream products move around a bit, but that's a nice green. It's not too green, too deep. So I'm going to go ahead and hold on to the color corrector, but I'm going to declutter the foundation. These are not really UK or European brand. This is KVD. They had a counter in their Debenhams, and I was lucky enough to find the Pearl Locket Powder. So I am 100% holding on to this. I bought like two of them. They were on clearance. And I also got the Gold Everlasting Lip Veil. I don't really do gold lips a lot, but I love these Everlasting Lip Veils. So I'm going to go ahead and hold on to that. These are two things that were kind of fun. I think Debenhams is no longer in Ireland at all. So it was kind of cool that I got to see. Debenhams was kind of the department store where they had a lot of things like you would find in a Macy's. So they had, I think like a Tarte and a Buxom and a KVD. And it was more of the kind of US brand. So that was kind of a fun thing to see. And then when you went to the drugstores and the pharmacies, that's where you got to see more of like the UK brands and the European brands. This is what I picked up from Barry M. This is Glitter Fixer Gel and a Glitter. I want to play around with this, so I haven't had a chance to play with this. This is a fun glitter, and I'm always looking for glitter glues, so I'm going to give this a shot. I am a little nervous about something that liquidy, so we'll see. If it doesn't work well, we'll get rid of that, no problem. But I'm going to hold on to the glitter for sure. All right, this is the only thing. I saw a big display of Flormar in this store called Penny's. So Penny's was sort of a mixture of like a TJ Maxx and a Forever 21 is kind of what it felt like, with a little bit of like home goods and stuff, but there was a lot of clothing and they had a pretty big makeup section. They had a whole selection of Flormar, and I only bought this loose powder because I needed a loose powder for my full face. And then I found out later that this is like a Turkish makeup brand. I did that whole video of the stuff that I picked up in Ireland. If I didn't link it already, I'll link it up in the cards. I think I did though. I wish I had bought more things from it because a lot of the other ones are just straight up UK brands. This was the only one that I know of that was from Turkey. So I thought that was kind of fun, but all I got was this loose powder. It was fine. I'm gonna go ahead and keep it for now. I am getting overstocked on powders. So once I do that full face of Irish trip makeup, I will probably declutter this after that. But I would like to try more from this brand. Then we have a couple of these cutesy products from Miss Lynn. These look kind of like they're kind of duping the vibe of the balm. So we have the Sweetie Cupcake Highlighter and the Beach Please Bronzer. So this is the pressed highlighter. This is pretty. I've played around with it a little bit. I mean, I love that the pan design stays there really nicely. It's just kind of a basic pinkish, yellowish mixed highlight. And then we have this bronzer. So I think I might have talked about it in the video as well. I actually left with the display where the bronzer had fallen out. I was in such a hurry. They were closing in like 10 minutes and I just grabbed it really quickly off the shelf. And I accidentally got the display one where the pan had just fallen out. And so I had to call and I was like, this is going to sound so stupid, but can I exchange it? And so I had to make another trip downtown the next day after work to get a replacement of this. So it was so dumb. But So after all that work, I want to keep this, and I'm going to need it for contour. So I'm going to go ahead and keep that. Do I need the cupcake highlighter? I mean, that's pretty, but there's nothing special about it. I'm going to declutter the cupcake highlighter. It's pretty, and it's cute, and it was nice at the time, but I just don't need it. All right, now we're down to like two groups of products. The first one is all like store brand products for a store called Primark. Now, from watching Make Me Up, Missa, my understanding about Primark is that it's kind of like a UK Walmart sort of thing, or like a discounty kind of store. And Penny's, that store that I talked about, carried a lot of their stuff. So these are a bunch of different things that I tried from them that I picked up. So this is a primer. This is the Prep and Perfect Daily Detox. I think this is supposed to be kind of a dupe. A lot of these, as we go through, you're gonna see are kind of meant to be sort of like dupe knockoff kind of products. And I think this is meant to sort of dupe the Urban Decay when they had their anti-pollution primer skincare type stuff. And so I'm gonna keep this because it is a nice, fun smoothing primer. I'm gonna go ahead and hold on to that. And then we have the Double Coverage Matte Foundation. I'm gonna go ahead and hold on to this just because it's a matte foundation, and I might end up, when I do the full face, I might mix this with the Radiant Max Factor, because the Max Factor looks like maybe it's gonna be a little too yellow, and I think if I mix it with this, it might give me, it'll matte it down a little bit and hopefully make it a better color. So I'm gonna hold on to that. This is the False Lash Queen. If you had seen the packaging, before I took it out of the packaging, this is so clearly meant to be like a ripoff of the Too Faced Better Than Sex, and unfortunately it's just not as good. The brush is not as good, and it does smell a bit off. So I'm gonna go ahead and just throw that away because I have had this for a while. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw this out. It's stanky. Now there were two products that were this Mina X Primark. Now Angie looked that up and I forget what she even found out about it. Maybe this was the Turkish brand. I don't know. But they did, like, it seems some sort of collab. I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of the concealer. Do I have another concealer if I get rid of that? I don't have a concealer, so I'm gonna have to hold on to this until I do that full face, just because I don't have a concealer if I get rid of this. But I think that's gonna go after I do the full face. And then this is like a red liquid lipstick. And this seems like a nice formula, and I like this red. So I'm gonna go ahead and hold on to this as well. So we're gonna keep the Mina products for now. And this, you may have guessed just by looking at it, this was in packaging that was very clearly trying to rip off, dupe, copy, whatever, the Kylie lip kits. And this is a pretty, like, corally pink sort of color. I'm gonna go ahead and keep this. I like this color. I think that this is a color that I would have bought in the Kylie, and maybe I did buy in the Kylie sort of formula, but it's a little bit of a thicker, moussier kind of formula, but I'm gonna go ahead and hold on to this. I like it. Then we have the Rose Quartz palette. And this is a collection of peachy, red, pink, a little bit berry kind of shades. This is fun. I'm gonna put this in the maybe pile for now. I have to come back to this. Because I have one other bigger eyeshadow palette, and we're gonna look at those. Because if I do a full face, obviously I need some eyeshadow, and we're going to look at which one of these would be a better fit. So this is a maybe. And I said I only had two more brands, but I was a liar and a whore. So I also had these three things from Collection. That was just their name, was just Collection. I'm gonna keep all three of these. This is like a shimmery, iridescent green highlighter. I mean, it's so pretty. And it's so minty that it's not like super off-putting green. I'm super excited to play with that. I think that's gonna be gorge. And then there's these two just like iridescent lip glosses. Why get rid of those? These are just pretty, the glam crystals. There's one that's more of kind of a pinky iridescent crystal glitter. Now they're very sheer. You just get like this little wash of glitter, but I think these will be fun to play with. So for now, I'm gonna hold on to all three of these shimmery, beautiful products. And one more thing from Collection that snuck in. This is another primer. This is the Primed and Ready. And this is Warm Apricot, and it's this beautiful, luminous, peachy gold sort of a primer. And I think I have to keep that as well. For us pale beasts, it's just got a nice kind of radiance to it. I don't know if you'll even be able to see that on camera. It's not super pigmented, which I like. And so it's just kind of a nice little subtle peachy glow. I'm going to keep that as well. All right, finally, for real this time, the last brand that I had in this group, and that is Makeup Obsession. And I love the packaging for Makeup Obsession. And let me tell you, when I found this brand in Boots, I thought it was hot shit because I thought I had discovered this new makeup brand and I thought it was so cute and so revolutionary. And then I come home and like 2 months later, they announced that it was going to be in Targets or in Target online. And I found out that it was just another Makeup Revolution brand. And I was so bitter. And I'm so sad that of the Makeup Revolution brands, this is the one that's hardest to get in the US because this, I think, has the most fun collections. It's pretty close with iHeart Revolution. iHeart Revolution has pretty cute stuff too. But I just love the packaging. I love the aesthetic. And I wish this was easier to get in the US. Now, this even out, I've said before that I'm trying to do away with some color correcting. I did keep that color corrector stick, so I'm gonna get rid of this primer. I'm pretty pink, but I'm not always like pink all the way through my face, so I don't know that I need a green primer. I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of that. I'm also gonna get rid of this. You can see that it's kind of leaked. This is the Fix It Spray, the Extra Hold Makeup Fixing Spray. And this started to leak and it's turned this weird yellow color. So that feels like a biohazard. That feels like something that just needs to go. It feels gross. So Makeup Obsession always does really cute little Halloween collections. This is called Be Very Afraid. I'm tempted to keep it because I love that it's a Halloween piece and I do think it's really fun, except it's two pressed glitters, first of all, which we know that I hate. And if you ignore the glitters, it's a kind of gray looking black, a gunmetal silver shimmer, two kind of deep purpley mauves, a brick red, and a beige. No, I don't need this. It's a cute idea, but I got drawn in by the Halloweeniness of it, which is weird because I think I went to Ireland in February or March, but I just was drawn in by the Halloween theme, and this needs to go. Then we have two blush palettes, the Mad About Mauve. So this is for kind of blush highlight shades. I think this marble shade is supposed to be a highlighter, but it's pretty deep. It's gonna be like a glowy blush. So I like these. I think these are fun. These are not the most exciting colors, but I do generally like this blush formula. And they're unique colors that I don't really have elsewhere in my collection. So I am going to hold on to this one. And I love a peachy blush moment like nobody's business. So I am absolutely holding on to this one. And I love that their palettes are magnetic. So you can actually take these out. So for example, if I only liked two of the peach and two of the mauve, I could combine them into one palette. And I love that they do that with their blushes and their eyeshadows. I think that's super fun. So I love that. I love blush. I think these are cute little palettes. They don't take up too much room, so I'm going to hold on to both of these. Now, our final product in this declutter. This is where we have to have that discussion. This is the Dream with a Vision palette. And this, you can see, is 16 pans. It's very pastel and beautiful. And if I'm going to do a full face, like I said, I want to have an eyeshadow palette. I've got like that green cream and stuff like that, but I need to be able to do a full look. So let me bring back that other palette. All right, so this is the Makeup Obsession palette. This is very pastel. It's pink and it's blue. There's a little bit of purple. It's very bright. This one is much more subdued, but you do get a matte black. I'm trying to think of other things that I have for the look. So I kept that green highlighter. With the green highlighter, it makes me think I should stick with this palette, just because this is gonna go a lot better with, and I could do one of those pink metallic. Although I do really like the reds in this, and I could do that red Mina X Primark lipstick. Oh, this is so hard. I don't know which of these to keep. I think, I mean, I could just keep both of them and declutter this one after I'm done with the look in case I need this, because I would also like to have this matte black. Because I have a matte white in here and then a matte black, which would help with all of that. This is so tough! Ugh. This is why I didn't film the declutter like this, because look at how much time this is taking. That's a beautiful shade. Oh my god, okay. That's a beautiful pink. That's pretty. Ah, I'm keeping both of these. I'm gonna keep both of them. I may rethink this one after the look is done, but I can't decide. I like both of these. So sorry. If you like Savage Declutters, I've always told you this is not the place to come. So these are both staying. All right, that is the end of my final declutter video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed this little adventure. Please consider subscribing to my channel and don't forget to head on over to JanessaJ.com and check out all of the posts that go along with these videos so you can see my entire collection. Thank you so much for watching. I am very excited and look for more upcoming fun content, but hopefully not a declutter for a long time. This wore me out. All right, that is it. That is the end of the declutter. I can't believe we made it through. It was a lot of work. It's a lot of makeup. I'm a little bit extra, but I hope you enjoyed it. Definitely let me know your thoughts down in the comments. What did you think of this whole declutter series? I definitely love to hear from you, and I'd love to hear what you'd like to see in maybe a 2022 declutter series. Can we look forward to the future? Let me know what you'd like to see. While you're down there, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. And you know what? If you want, go ahead and give it a thumbs down. The algorithm doesn't care. They're not a picky bitch, and neither am I. While you're down near that comment section, don't forget you can hit that subscribe button and stick around. And you can also hit that bell notification icon so you will get notified of all future uploads. I upload at least one video a week, and sometimes I even have a bonus video for you. You're so giving. If you'd like to chat, banter, or commiserate between uploads, all of my social media will be linked down in the description box below, including a link to my website, The World of Champagne at JanessaJ.com. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this declutter. I enjoy a declutter. I definitely was not as savage as some people would like me to be, but I had a good time with it. I hope you did too. And until I see you again, bye.